Well, good afternoon. I'm providing you with some very good feedback about what's the advocacy work that I've been doing. I'd like to let you know that I have been in touch with a local Member of Parliament, Tarnya Smith, to see about the possibility, now that the Newman administration has appointed ministers who will be sworn in on Tuesday by the Governor. But I'm specifically contacted Tarnya Smith, who is my local MP where I am, to liaise with the new Disability Minister, Tracy Davis, to see about the possibility of a special part of support and representation for persons on the autism spectrum. Of course, this needs to be approved by the government and by the minister concerned, but my idea would be that I would be able to work with Tarnya to provide a voice in government for persons on the autism spectrum in Queensland. The idea would be that the support that I would provide, or the information I would provide, would be able to assist Tarnya to be able to advise the Minister, Tracy Davis, about issues affecting adults on the autism spectrum and children. Of course, this needs to be approved, and the idea would also be that once a month I would meet with Tarnya to raise issues with her about ways of improving support and services for the adult autism community and also children, etc. I also would like to meet with Tarnya and within the portfolio of possible of disability about the National Disability Insurance Scheme. I've received two large volumes which I have shown to you earlier regarding the National Disability Insurance Scheme. My idea would be to be able to sit with Tarnya and other persons interested to find out the real nitty-gritty of what the National Disability Insurance Scheme is and how it can provide support and services for adults on the autism spectrum. So this is something that, if successful, would provide a voice in government for adults on the autism spectrum and persons on the autism spectrum. Also, it may also be able to help Tarnya Marshall, who is on the Sunshine Coast trying to start a school for autistic children and young adults there. So this is something that would greatly be valued if it started to become enacted. Also, it may assist, for instance, Damien Santa Maria, who's an adult on the autism spectrum, doing valuable research into young adults within his PhD. So there's a whole lot of factors that need to be factored into this sort of situation. So that's good news on that front. As you're all aware, that on Tuesday night, I will be visiting the Australia-New Zealand Software Testing Board with Gordon Sanderson, who is assisting me in terms of my advocacy work. I will be going along with Gordon, who has a son on the autism spectrum, to find out about what can be done to get software testing started here in Queensland. So for anybody that's interested, anybody in the past that I have had contact with regarding software testing, I encourage you to please join me and support me, or support the cause in trying to get software testing happening here in Brisbane, so we can start within the Southern Hemisphere of employing adults on the autism spectrum as software testers. So it's important that we just find out what's actually, if we can start the ball rolling in terms of getting something happening here. In terms of other things that are happening, I'm still working in my current job, and the other day, for instance, I did quite a lot of work in my capacity as a service support assistant in the university library, processing over 500 books and actually getting these books checked in and getting them as best I can on the shelves within the library, sorted, etc. I feel that I did a good job. I feel that by doing the work I'm doing, that it provides opportunity and incentive that people can start employing people with disabilities, particularly the autism spectrum. Because no doubt, people on the autism spectrum don't want to just exist on a welfare payment. They want to make a contribution to society, and they need to be given that opportunity. As most of you were aware, that in Friday's Courier Mail, this was Friday, the 29th of March, that Tom Collett, an adult with autism, featured in the Courier Mail with a plea for employers to start taking on people with autism. So there's a lot happening and a lot that needs to be done here in Queensland. So if anybody watching this YouTube video, please stay tuned for further updates. I have heard from Tarnya Smith this afternoon, and she's going to contact Tracy Davis to find out about whether or not my idea for a portfolio or assistance for the autism spectrum may become a reality and thus a voice in the Queensland Parliament. But please stay tuned to my YouTube video for more updates. Thanks again for watching this video. I'd like to say that my videos now are coming from an iPad, which I purchased the other day. The reason I am able to purchase things is because I save money. I don't spend it unnecessarily. And the new iPad is making life a heck of a lot easier because I can actually, rather than use the iPhone, which I previously did, I can use now the iPad and be able to transmit and record these videos so that they're available on YouTube for other people to watch. So have a lovely afternoon, and please stay tuned to my YouTube page for more information and updates. Thanks very much.